Hi, this is Terrence Evans, and we're live from Vancouver, British Columbia. We're doing our special today on the American artist. Yes, we have with us in the studio on the phone from Kansas City, Missouri in the USA, or I should say US of A, Coca Leaves. Coca Leaves is a guy that I talked to. We're going to read his bio here. We're changing the show format a little bit, and we've got Van City Gossip Girl here to read the bio. Go ahead, Ms. Van City Gossip Girl.
Hey, Vancouver, what's up? It's Van City Gossip Girl. So I'm here to introduce our next artist. His name is Coca Leaves. He grew up in Kansas City, Missouri, and always knew rapping would be part of his future. Like most young talent, he started rapping at age 5 and never stopped. Street kid to rap artist was a natural transition. Writing his first rap at 12, had his first live performance at 15, joining his first group at 16. Now at 33, street religion is what he calls his current music style. Life has its lessons it wants to teach, and after being locked up for 6.5 years on 3 felony charges, now it's his time to let it all out. Everything he speaks on, from guns, drugs, religion, incarceration, he lived all of it. After incarceration, rejection from family and friends, he almost gave up music. But he recorded a verse with a relative, putting all his pain and rejection behind it, and the city called out to him, called him to come back to his passion. Rakim has also been one of his major influences because he is a Muslim and a thinker. Islam plays a huge role in Coca's life, giving him strength and drive to continue the path he began at a young age. He has opened up for major performing artists all over, including R. Kelly, Salt-N-Pepa, Twista, Tech N9ne, SWV, Too Short, and Mac 10.
All right, and we'll be right back after this commercial break and PSA with Coca Leaves.
I became a Big Sister because I recognized a need for an older role model while I was growing up, even though I had a great mom. My hope is that I have helped my little sister to open her eyes beyond what narrow experiences her home life was giving her.
Big Sisters of BC Lower Mainland provides each of our little sisters with a mentor who is there to listen to her, cheer her on, and be a supportive friend. If you are a woman who is age 19 or older, you can become a Big Sister and hang out with your little sister once a week, doing fun activities you both enjoy. For more information, visit www.bigsisters.bc.ca.
If you'd like to talk about exploring gay, lesbian, transgender, queer, and bisexual identities, the trained volunteers from the peer support team of Out on Campus would love to meet with you. A meeting is possible anywhere on campus. There is also an opportunity to chat online. For more information, send an email to ooc-peersupport@sfu.ca.
All right, and we're back on the air with Coca Leaves. Coca Leaves, how are you?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm good, man. You know, I find it kind of weird calling you Coca Leaves. Can I call you something else? What's your first name? Rashid, right?
No, that's my second name. Khalid. Khalid is my, well, you know, some people say it's hard to say Khalid, so they say Khaled, like DJ Khaled. It's basically the same thing, but it's just the I and the E that's only make the difference. It means the same thing.
Okay, all right. So, you know, I our show is a little bit different, right? And we kind of ship our shows all over the world and really try to get the people out there, the artists out there. I want to talk a little bit about your life. You know, I was listening to the bio, and I read the bio last week about everything that you sing about, you've been. So does that mean that you were like one of those kingpin drug dealers that you see on TV? Is that what you did?
I wouldn't necessarily say a kingpin status, nothing like that. But nothing like that, though. You know, but most of them turned over, though. They, you know, turned on their people. No, I didn't have to do none of that, though. But,
yeah
I mean, like I said, I've been incarcerated, though. You know what I'm saying? I mean, this last one right here was the longest one. Like I said, I've been a total of like 4 incarcerations. You know what I'm saying? I had like three felony convictions, though, 2 in Missouri and 1 in Kansas.
So,
you know what I'm saying? To me, you know what I'm saying? I don't really know how to, you know what I'm saying, tell you nothing fake and made up. Everything I tell you is
real. Exactly.
So, yeah,
exactly.
Know? Yeah.
Wow. So, You know, let's get into a little bit about your life. How did you get incarcerated? I mean, don't they have that rule in the States, three strikes and you're out?
Well, like I said, I'm two in Missouri, and I'm one in the state of Kansas.
Ah, okay.
That's where I caught the break at, you know what I'm saying?
Okay.
With this last one, I mean, I was facing the possibility of almost a life in prison, you know.
Wow.
But,
wow. So do you mind me asking what some of your charges are?
I have some attempt to forgery and, you know what I'm saying, and some drug convictions and stuff like that. That's mainly it, you know what I'm saying?
Okay.
But I have, you know, this petty, with the little stuff, you know, I'm glad it was the little petty stuff that I got, you know what I'm saying, caught up with, though, you know what I'm saying? So
yeah.
Instead of something else happened, you know, yeah.
Wow, that's good, man. That's good.
Yeah.
So let's get on to a little bit about you. So you've been singing for how long now?
Like I said, performing. Like I said, I've been, you know, doing the performing thing, you know, since I was about five, and actually recording since 15, off and on. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know these stints. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know, if you're incarcerated, you can't really perform. I mean, you know, do recording no music or nothing like
exactly,
that.
Exactly, exactly.
Yeah, but you know, off and on and stuff like that, though. But like I said, I only been on for like maybe like what today about the 20th month, though, basically.
Okay.
So you know what I'm saying, and this 20th, you know what I'm saying, 20, you know, months that I done been home, I done, you know what I'm saying, kind of, you know what I'm saying, accomplished a lot, though, you know what I'm saying, surpassed a lot of, you know what I'm saying, cast that's kind of established, you know what I'm saying, in the city, they got a lot of big fan base, you know what I'm saying, call themselves kings of Kansas City and stuff like that, though.
Exactly,
too.
Exactly.
Yeah.
So talk to me about, you said you opened for R. Kelly.
this was before this was going on, you know what I'm saying? Like, a lot of them performances, like, you know, like early, like late 90s.
Okay, okay.
Early 2000s and stuff like that, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, I was able to sit down. He came up here and did a show at Kemper Arena up here. It was him. Mm-hmm. LL Cool J and the group Escape, so you know that was a long time.
Oh, that was big though. That was big back in the day, hey.
Yeah. So they came and did that thing and stuff like that, and that was a good experience. I get down and, you know, sit down and talk to them and, you know, sending out that type of stuff, and it was a good thing when I, you know, perform with these type of people.
Yes, yes.
And it was like, well, you know what I'm saying, I appreciate it because, you know, I wasn't even at the, you know, perfection of my craft. I didn't have that really nothing down there. I was just kind of starting out. You know what I'm saying, and stuff like that. And they was like, well, good job, man. Keep on doing what you was doing and stuff
exactly,
like that.
Exactly.
You know, so that was a good, you know what I'm saying, a push, too.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying, too, that it kind of helped me, you know what I'm saying, like the decision, like later on what happened in the bio. Like, a lot of people was like, man, are you still doing it? I was like, nah, man, I ain't doing it. They was like, man, come on, man, you need to go. So, you know, and I thought about them, their performances, too, and what they kind of been to all those people that, you know what I'm saying, and what they going through now and
exactly.
All that. And they still able to overcome and stuff like that. So that was a push too to help me come on, keep on doing the music and stuff like that to where I'm at now.
All right. So why don't we let people hear one of your songs? I got three of your songs. Which one would you like me to play first?
I guess the Coca Leaves, I guess, featuring for Finesse, the You song. I you know, because I'm shooting a video for this, so you know, it's played on like. Most of the songs I sent you is played like on, you know, different other radio stations, like in heavy rotation. So I just
want
to hear it from your standpoint and your audience, you know what I'm saying? Since the song is for the women anyway, the ladies.
Okay.
I just wanted to hear it from them, though, you know, because I do it for them, you know, anyway, you know. So I want to get their standpoint and tell me how they think about it, you know. Yeah.
Okay, awesome. All right, so you heard it here first. This is You from Coca Leaves out of Kansas City, Missouri. All right.
Like Chanel, seeing Christian Dior suits with happy stuck like goo. Couldn't wait to get off the block. and flip this four-way and eight balls and re-up the closed down shop. Doing a buck 50 on the highway, lustin', fiendin' just to play house and get right next to you. Thank God, every time you let me touch you, honey, throwing a Mac, maneuver through the waters as a Navy SEAL. But I had my gear so bad, but I skied up in your mouth, you spit it back up like rebirth whenever I was on one. The fam always calls you up, you never resist to get up out of bed and catch a cat. Swoop me up and roll down the window, tell me constantly to be, baby, breathe. While pressing on my hands, tell me get home. Catch the CD playing, hide the CDs under the seat, and lock with the cars at the alarm. Carrying me inside home and dressing empty on pockets, put my money in the safe and gun on safety and tucked away in the pillow. My product on the dress and tell me, Coca, I love you. But watch the ESPN until I fall asleep. No fussing, no fighting. The next day, wake up to breakfast and business. Push me roll to take to the head.
You, baby. You
are so wonderful.
All right, that was Coca Leaves You here live on TNT Events Radio. That's pretty good tunes, man. So, what inspired that?
It was a lot. It was some females, but it was one particular female that played a key part in that. You know, so I kind of thought about that. You know, saying that, you know, LL Cool J did I Need Love, so that was kind of, you know, my version. You know what I'm saying? My version with a twist on it, you know, and stuff like that. But there was a particular one female, though, like I said, when I used to be out on the streets and stuff like that, though, so she kind of, you know, kind of held me down and stuff like that, though. So she played a key part, and so, you know, I just thought about her, and I said, well, let me do something for her, you know what I'm saying, and stuff like that, though, yeah. So I just paid homage to her, though, you know, showed her my, you know, since she blessed me, I just been blessed back on the track. That was basically it, you know.
Exactly. So, what have you been up to as of late? Like, what has Coca been up to?
Well, here lately, I mean, I guess I'm a man of different hats. like I said, I'm a CEO. I got my own label, Silverback Records.
All right. Do you have people signed to your label or?
No, not yet. I'm just basically the only artist, you know what I'm saying, on this label.
Okay.
But I'm also a partner with a female artist, you know what I'm saying, named Shauna Pat. You know what I'm saying? I was out with a CEO and A&R position with her company with Young Rock Entertainment.
Okay. All right.
Yeah, so I'm doing that. I had, you know, my own little clothing line.
Yeah.
And then I'm with another guy, you know what I'm saying? I'm with somebody else too. We got a clothing line for those, you know, tattoo artists.
Okay.
So, you know what I'm saying? I'm kind of, you know what I'm saying, a co-chairman and marketing director of that one.
Okay.
And like I said, I'm hosting Coast to Coast mixtapes, doing all, you know, all type of things. I'm supposed to sign a production deal too with a company called Abyss Productions.
Okay.
So I'm doing that, you know what I'm saying? Like I said, a man of many hats. I'm putting together, so you know, since you asked questions about my life, I'm putting together Well, I'm getting it. I'm typing it up. A book called Memoirs of a Hustler. Over, you know, seeing I got those pictures like that on my Facebook page and all that.
Yes,
So I'm putting that together. So you know what I'm saying. I got little videos on YouTube about that, but it'll go really in depth from you know what happened from a youth all the way to now to play the real key part. You know what I'm saying. What pushed me to the brink of what happened, you know what I'm saying, to do those things and stuff like this.
So exactly.
You can have a better understanding of who I am, you know.
Yeah. All right, we're going to take another commercial break. You're listening to TNT Events Radio, broadcasting from CJSF 90.1 FM. Broadcasting from Burnaby, British Columbia, also on the internet at cjsf.ca, and TELUS HDTV 3706. The request line is not open. We'll be right back.
GAB Youth Services is a place for lesbian, gay, transgender, and two-spirit youth to find support, make some friends, get information, and to participate in activities. We provide one-on-one support, run regular drop-ins, talk to youth and adults on combating homophobia and discrimination, organize dances and special events, plus much, much more. We are located at 1170 Butte Street in Vancouver. If you're nervous about coming to a drop-in by yourself, call ahead and we can have another youth meet you for coffee first. For more information, please visit www.lgtbcentervancouver.com or call 604-684-4901.
And we're back here with Coca Leaves. We're going to bust into another one of your songs. The second song that we have here is called, what's the name of this song? Sorry. Let me just get it. Which one do you want us to play next?
I guess we can go with What's Gangster.
With Gangster?
Yeah, What's Gangster, yeah.
Okay, so this is Gangster.
Full-time hustler, posted on the block, gotta get it to live. And I'm never gon' stop, now that gangsta. Now that gangsta. When the right show the hood, you can hear the bass knock on the girl, them love me. Me, I'm missing the lock, now that gangsta.
Everybody marked up like a subway in Harlem don't make you gangster. Wearing bananas and toting bananas don't make you gangster. Being able to recite literature don't make you gangster. Smoking trees any color fam don't make you gangster. Dropping out of school to be the man and buying joints of Air Maxes don't make you gangster. Riding around on candy duds, showing off a competition and bragging rights don't make you gangster. Run up a nigga's crib with business don't make you gangster. Getting pussy 7 days a week don't make you gangster. Wanna be Nina Brown? Don't make you gangster. When white beaters and snackbacks don't make you gangster. Walking around with your chuck ass out, don't make you gangster.
I'm a full-time hustler, posted on the block, gotta get it to live. And I'm never gon' stop, now that gangster. Now that gangster. When the right show the old, you can hear the bass knock on the girl, them love me. Me, I'm missing the lock, now that gangster.
Off your grill, don't make you gangster. Robbing senior citizens, don't make you gangster. Trying to represent a block movement, throwing up sets, don't make you gangster. Wearing bulletproof vests, don't make you gangster. Recording yourself on camcorder, smoke a bunch and flash a gun and stack some money. Having hood rats say something, don't make you gangster. Stealing weed and money from your family to share with the homies, don't make you gangster. Being on around KC can get in the club VIP just for free, don't make you gangster. What's gangster is staying in school. Though college is for everybody, keeping an open mind for Plan B as your option, and walk across the stage. That's gangster.
I'm a full-time hustler, posted on the block, gotta get it to live, and I'm never gon' stop. Now that gangster, now that gangster. When the right show the old, you can hear the bass knock on the girl, them love me. Me, I'm missing the lock. Now that gangster, now that gangster.
It's gangster in the free world of pen, pay child support. If you know somebody can't read or write, don't belittle them, teach what's right. Don't smoke drugs in front of your kids. Take the cussing, yelling, and fighting. in the bedroom. Have some respect for yourself. Start running from responsibilities. Suck up in the air and walk outside and take what life gon' bring you. Move out your parents' house, out to somebody else's house. That means you're home, cause ain't nothing like your own. Stick your wheels to God factory only, so the feds can miss you. If you do it in the pen, pick up they kids. Bringing the visits, provide pampers, baby food and clothes. Out of kindness for a pretty heart that's gangster.
I'm a full-time hustler, posted on the block, gotta get it till I live. And I'm never gon' stop, not a gangster. When the right show the old, you can hear the bass knock on the girl, them love me. Me, I'm a city lock, now the gangster.
To Bumbo Clot Man, that was the gangsta. That's pretty good, man. Are you there? Are you there?
Yeah, I'm here. I'm
okay.
Here.
I like that, man. You were singing that with Sean Kingston,
yeah,
right?
Yeah. He got, yeah, that's the hook. Yeah. I mean, it's just, it's original, a remake, basically, though. You know?
Yeah.
I just put my twist on it.
Okay.
And I had to tell people basically that everything that you're talking about, you know what I'm saying, what's going on, that's not what's gangster, man. You know, so.
Exactly.
That was my conscious. When I try to drop jewels, like on every album or something like that, I try to drop a jewel for them, you know what I'm saying, somebody for them to soak up, you know what I'm saying, because I just use mine, you know what I'm saying, everything with me, you know what I'm saying, as a learning lesson, though, you know what I'm
exactly.
saying, stuff like
exactly.
that. So I just trying to help somebody to grow and mature, you know what I'm saying, and step on up to the plate, you know. And being that we artists, we have responsibility that, you know, we play a key part that, you know what I'm saying, that we listen, we make this music and people listen to this thing. You know, music is very influential.
Influential, exactly. It's universal. You know, music is universal.
Yeah. It's a universal language, so I try to tell people that, you know what I'm saying, that we need to step up to the plate, and as artists, that's what you need to do. So, you know, I mean, I'm in my 30s, so I can't be, you know, rapping about that, and I don't sag my pants or do none of that. So, you know what I'm saying? I would just tell them, basically, you're just going to have to kind of grow up, basically. You know?
Exactly.
Yeah.
Wow, man. You got some pretty good tunes there. You're pretty good. How did you start off into the business?
It was kind of a trip. Like, you know, so like I say, the first one I wrote, it was supposed to be like a love letter, you know what I'm saying, and stuff
that. Yep.
And I guess she didn't like what I put in the thing, the female who I wrote it to, and she kind of sent a reply back like a diss. I guess it was a diss track, but, you know, back then that's what it was. And so, you know, the reply back, and I read the thing, and I seen it, and everybody was like, ooh, man, she talked bad. I said, no, this will never happen again. So, you know, I just kind of moved forward with that thing, and then, you know, since every experience that I done been through, I just kind of incorporated that, you know, sending the music, though, you know what I'm saying? I mean, at times, like I said, I didn't want to really do it, you know what I'm saying, because the streets, it was a struggle, you know, because the music wasn't paying, you know what I'm saying, it wasn't paying out, you know what I'm saying, the difference between, because I've been in a group and solo artists, and I done been, you know, so I've been a lot of deals and stuff like that with some major labels and stuff like that, and, you know, I find more success now as a solo artist, though, because I came into my own and stuff like that, though, too, so I just continue to keep on pushing, though, you know what I'm saying? I done been through it, the management, shady management deals, I've been in a situation like death row type of situation, though, so, I mean, yeah, so, I just keep on pushing, though, you know, and been through it all, you know?
I hear you. So, you know, what kind of advice would you have for people that are, let's say young kids, you know, that are listening? We ask this question of everybody. Give me 3 points that you would tell people getting started in the business or wanting to get into the business. 3 important points. What would that be?
To do your homework, basically. You know what I'm saying? I mean, being that if you just want to rap, I mean, it's really like really no, you know what I'm saying? A lot of artists say this, though. You know what I'm saying? It's really no music, money, and being an artist, really, kind of, though. You know what I'm saying? You kind of branch out and do different things, you know, open up a different umbrella. So you got to kind of know what you're doing, though. And when you're signing these deals, you got to kind of know, I mean, you know, because if you see it on TV, they got the small print on the TV ads, though. You know what I'm saying? So in the contract language, I mean, it's a whole different type of language. So you need to try to get some. If you're in high school and stuff like that, I know you may be not able to go to college or something like that, but you need to read as many books as possible, or if not, Google, you know what I'm saying, and YouTube, and learn anything about business law or music business. And know the position of a manager, an A&R, and all those type of people. So when you go talk to these people, you can go ahead and do that. But you really don't need a manager at the same time. You can get an entertainment lawyer or agent, and they can go ahead and solicit material to us, record labels for you, though. So, I mean, it's whatever you want to do. I mean, if you want to go the independent route, you got to do what's best for you. You know what I'm saying? I mean, you know, you need to pray on, you know what I'm saying, on that, too. I don't know, you know what I'm saying, if your religion's a key part, but pray on every decision and what it is, though. You know what I'm saying? Don't be quick to rush them just because you want a deal and it sounds good, because, you know, I mean, being on a, if they give you a 5-album deal, I mean, you might not even make it for the first year out the first album. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, you might can be signing your whole life away. So you need to, like I said, do a lot of reading and studying, man, and, you know, a lot of praying, too, on that thing, too, man. You know what I'm saying? And you know, listen to those around you, you know what I'm saying? And, you know, read books, though. You know what I'm saying? Learn about the history of music, though, from, you know, from Motown to jazz classical artists, and, you know, listen to those people type of stories and you know what I'm saying, and see what they went through, because, you know, cause that still can happen to you. Just because it might happen 20 years ago, it still can happen, you know what I'm saying? So you
exactly,
need to
exactly.
Everything was going on, yeah.
Exactly. So, you know, let's touch a little bit. Are you Muslim? Are you Muslim?
Oh, yeah. I'm not Nation of Islam. I'm like I'm out Islam. I'm it's a difference though. Yeah, I'm, you know, yeah, I'm a Muslim. Yeah.
What's the difference between Nation of Islam and out Islam?
Well, the Nation of Islam, you know, they follow up under, you know, saying they say Prophet, you know, saying Elijah Muhammad, you know, saying
yes.
Minister Farrakhan. You know, I don't, you know, I mean when Islam was introduced to me at the age of 16, though, it was introduced to me by somebody that was a part of the Nation of Islam, but I wasn't able. I didn't really. I mean, that's when I picked out my Muslim name and. You know what I'm saying, and kind of, you know what I'm saying, read about it and stuff and did
yes.
My thing on that. But it wasn't in then, you know what I'm saying, until like, you know what I'm saying, basically this incarceration when I went ahead and did the thing for the whole thing for, you know, taking my Shahada, though. Basically, you know what I'm saying, we follow up under the Prophet Muhammad, though, you know what I'm saying, mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying, because it's the difference between Sunnis and Shiites, too, you know what I'm saying. Islam is like a Sunni Muslim, though, so that's why I follow up under
okay.
You know what I'm saying? I, you know, incorporate that in the music, though, and stuff like that, though, too. Mm-hmm. So, mm-hmm. I mean, I explain the difference between that with people. Like I said, I got a video on that and how Islam was introduced to me and stuff like that.
Okay. Is that the video that I have? Is that the video that I have?
The video you have is my first video that
the
I have.
You. The You one?
No, the video. I think I sent you. I think it's the Coca Leaves That Go Hard.
Yes, that's it. Yeah.
I think that was the first video that I was recorded, though. You know what I'm saying? So,
okay.
Yeah, that was the first one that I recorded. But I mean, it's on my YouTube page, though. The videos that it was. It's actually on my website too. It's on my YouTube page and my website, though, too. So.
Okay. We got about 4 minutes left here in the interview. So what I want to do is I want to get. Your name and your contact details out there, so if people want to contact you or okay. Visit your websites, how do they do that?
Okay, well, they can if they go on Twitter, they can mm-hmm. follow me at my which is it's Khalid Khalid Rashid Rashed 17. That's my Twitter. On Facebook, is you can find me on at Coca Leaves. You can go on my website, which is you know, www.kokalevesmusic.com.
Okay.
Go on there. You'll see all the videos that I have. You'll see the snapbacks, the T-shirts, the hoodies on there if you want to purchase that.
All right, yeah, because you're sending me out a couple CDs and hoodies, right?
Yeah, I got you.
Okay,
I got
good,
you.
Good.
As a matter of fact, when I get done with the interview, I'm headed out the way to go ahead and get some pressed on up and stuff like that, because I got to send some to not only you, but the other DJs, and I got to send some over to Africa and all that type of stuff, though, too. You know, I'm trying to be worldwide.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Okay, my friend, so we're going to play you out with the next song, which is called Got Work. Do you want to give a little bit of backdrop on Got Work?
Your Back Work was basically the first song I recorded when I first decided to go ahead and start it on my solo album.
Mm-hmm.
And that was the first work, first song I done, though, you know what I'm saying? You said I just come home from doing, you know, 6.5 years. That's what, you know, I come on and explain the situation.
Yeah.
You know, putting in job applications of what was going on and all that. So basically, it was just basically telling them that, you know, y'all let me up in the game, though, you know what I'm saying? So now I got work to do, you know what I'm saying? Basically, that's what I was just telling them.
Okay, all right, so here is Got Work, Coca Leaves. Thanks for coming on to the show, and we'll talk to you again soon, okay?
Okay, all right, I appreciate it.
Okay, man, bye-bye.
No problem, bye-bye.
Just come home from doing 6.5 years. Criminal minor, rapping hood on mine until they free moon me. Niggas ain't happy to see me. I got work to do, no longer promise record it from Cormac Grimes. I got work to do. Can't fit my clothes, wearing hand-me-downs. I got work to do. Save with mine's got 6 months, get my shit right. I got work to do, don't wanna bite the hand and feed me. I'm no longer a baby boy, I'm 33 years old, can't see eye to eye. I'm always liming Sunni Muslim. She practice Sunday morning, only Christian believe when sure she going to heaven. Nigga dropped a dime on Sydney, wait on the case. Feed him the kind and beat the case. Niggas need full-time canteen and flicks and five for food stamps and SSI. Putting in applications, tired of dealing with rejection late in that quarter. Which motherfuckers give me a break? I got work to do. I got work to do. Ain't made a lot in a while. Made it to the mass year due to lack of treasure. Takes too much pride to catch the bus. Allah know my attention. It's still Ash and Do. Allah, Illallah, Ash, Do, and Muhammad. Rasulullah, tag, bitch, tag, big. Auto Akbar. Since I got a ticket today, but fire tag, struggling, make ends meet. Then Jesus can help her through the hard times. It breaks my heart, cause I promise to get this out the hood. I got work to do. Refuse to be on my case season. Long as he fucking with you, wheels. Gotta stick by the G code. I got work to do. Feel like a bare naked when I see Delio get his hustle on. Can't hate cause I got people who love. Kansas City want me to stick to the news. When I'm ready to call up a leaf, baby. Cop a big gate and stretch to the 9 hours and a turn of the 15 six. Waiting on a drought, a duck take the bird man. Daughter swap it out for 5Ks or 100 bricks. I got work to do.
Yeah. Ladies and gentlemen, it's your boy Cocalees. The nigga that dropped that motherfucking verse and told you niggas I'm back on that motherfucking Obey. And that nigga that's about to fuck the game up. You know what I'm saying? I got my people with me, Kansas Smitty, T.O. Sidus, Roller the Monster, MJ Appeal, and my nigga Little Fago, or should I say AKA Hercules, and this bitch with me, man. You know what I'm talking about? You niggas done fucked up, man. You know what I'm saying? Let a nigga that don't even rap up in this motherfucking game, man.
Already. Okay.
Oh, yeah, that's all good.
All right, so Mr. Ray Gill.
How you doing, bro? How you doing?
Good, man. Is that your stage name? Is that the name that you go by?
Yeah, that's my name, Ray Gill, man.
Okay.
That's what it is.
And where do you play out of, Ray?
We're just making so many moves right now. We're growing at a great pace. We're doing shows. We started off doing shows in Surrey. Now we've branched out all over Vancouver. We got a monthly night in Surrey that we do at Olympia's Pizza. Mm-hmm. And then we're at different places in Van all the time. So you just got to go to Van, and you can get all the shows, all the info.
Okay, cool. So why don't you tell me a little bit about you? When did you start off? What inspired you? That kind of stuff.
Okay, well, yeah, I just started freestyling, when I was around 16 and stuff. Kind of got in, with the bad crowd and stuff like that. And, you know, like hip-hop was just my thing. And, you know, I just started getting in the studio, taking it seriously about, three years ago. And dropped my first mixtape, and the response was amazing. And because I'm Indian, and there's no Indian hip hop artists that are really doing that West Coast style that I have,
mm-hmm.
So it's really unique. It's really amazing, and you know, we're getting thousands of hits on YouTube. You know, we're just making hits, and we're just looking for the right situation right now, and so we can take it to the next level.
All right, you keep saying we. Who is we? Who is we with you?
That's my fans. That's the people that I work with. You know, like I got music videos. I got, two mixtapes out, and I couldn't do it alone. Not only with the fans, but my team, my video guy. My video guy Freeze One, my engineer Will Stelfox. The list goes on. So it takes more than just me. It looks like it's only me, but there's a lot behind the scenes that happens to make you one of the hottest Indian hip hop artists in Canada.
Okay. All right, man. So you sent me, I think it was two or three songs?
Yes, I did. I sent you some of our most popular songs. Yeah.
All right. Let's give people a little bit of clue on you. What are one of the songs that, or the first song that you want to play so people can actually get an idea of who Ray Gill is?
Okay, well, basically, it's Till the End. The song's called Till the End. It's featuring my homie from India, Uday Dinoa. You know, I branched out international for this collaboration. And basically, it's a great song. And the video just dropped last week. We've already got over 5,000 views on YouTube. And, you know, it's raygill.net. My add me on Facebook. Look at the video. The video is amazing. It's one of the hottest videos out right now. It's just amazing. And we got a hot Asian girl in there, and we're just breaking boundaries all over. So,
all right, you should definitely send that video to me, too, all right?
I'll send it to you today, yes.
All right. So the name of this song is... Breaking it down.
Till the End.
Oh, Till the End. Till the End. All right, so this is Ray Gill, Till the End.
And when it feels like you can't go on, just keep your head so strong. Just live your life till the end.
Till the end, till the end.
Just breathe in the sweet air. Feels like you're already there. No one can hold you down. Hold you down, hold you down.
I see you bitching, acting tough. You know this is love.
Uh-huh.
You want me, baby, can't get enough.
That's right.
I'm ready to call you bluff. You acting tough, you want a rough game. Recognize game, I see you. Passion never see through. Not a hater, but I hate to leave you. The end is not coming, we hot, running. Take it to the top, stunting. First class flight, room service, you deserve it. Yeah, we living so good, never tripping. Bedroom friction, Trojans on the ground. You loving the sound, I'm the king, baby girl, where's my crown? Ray Gill, hold it down. In that pussy, I'ma drown. In that pussy, I'ma drown.
Swag,
and when it feels like you can't go home, just keep your head so strong. Just live your life till the end.
Till the end, till the end.
Just breathe in the sweet air. Feels like you're already there. No one can hold you.
Wake up, wake up, living a dream. I'ma put you on the team. You know me, rolling joints up in the sand, calling me your man. I'm in the forest like Tarzan, your ex acting so mad. I'm living plush life, 5-star suites, sports car whipping, Molly tripping, rum sipping. Yeah, you know that we winning, flamingos and jackpots. You know that it's mad hot, rageous, I can't stop. And I will just not, lady, you like my motivation. And the fact that I'm never hating, and I'm always spoiling you when we dating. Keeping it real, I'm never faking. Welcome to my meditation. Listen to me on the station. I'm having fun while you waiting. Hop in the whip and let's go, go, go.
When it feels like you can't go home, just keep your head so strong. Just live your life till the end.
Till the end, till the end.
Just breathe in the sweet air. Feels like you're already there. No one can hold you down.
Hold you down, hold you down.
And when it feels like you can't go home, your head so strong, just live your life till the end.
Till the end, till the end.
Just breathe in the sweet air. Feels like you're already there. No one can hold you down.
Hold you down, hold you down.
And when it feels like you can't go home, just keep your head so strong. Just live your life till the end.
Till the end, till the end.
Just breathe in the sweet air. Feels like you're already there. No one can hold you down, hold you down, hold you down.
Did you know that parts of the Canada Arm were made in Richmond, or that the small farming town is actually a leader in global innovation? Richmond went from its small town roots to becoming today's technological gateway, and the Richmond Museum's newest exhibit, The Cutting Edge, asks the question, how? The Richmond Museum is located at 7700 Mineral Gate, inside the Richmond Cultural Center. Admission is by donation. The Cutting Edge exhibit will run until June 23, 2011. For more information, search Richmond Museum online or call 604-247-8333.
All right, Ray, that was actually really good. What inspired you to do that song? What was it about?
I've been in a lot of crazy relationships, and I'm single right now. I'm just focused on my music. So, growing up with just all my experiences in life, you know, my dating experiences. You know, I used to, you know, hang out with the bad crowd, like I said. I turned my life around. Now I'm doing the music thing, you know. So it's just it's such so much happening at the same time. So I just take from everything, you know, either stuff I've been through or stuff that I've experienced or my friends have been through. And, you know, I just write it down.
Okay. All right. Well, Ray, you know, a lot of kids are out there. And there's a lot of people that think they can be rappers or want to be rappers or weekend rappers. And what's some advice that you can give somebody who's looking at getting into the industry? In BC.
You know what?
In BC.
Well, basically, you know what? The rap game is like the dope game, right? You know what? It's doggy dog, and it's not all fun and games. When I first came in, I was really naive. I thought that because I had a little bit of talent, people would be knocking down my door wanting to help me. It was totally the opposite. You know, there's a lot of politics, there's a lot of competition. You know, there's only enough record deals to go around. Everybody wants their piece of the pie. So you got to do it for the love. If you don't love it, you'll quit before you even get to where you need to go. I've been through some crazy downs, but I rode them out because I love hip-hop. I love the music. This is what my passion, what I was born to do. And because that passion just kept me going through the bumps, man, because some of the bumps can be really bad, you know. There was a time when I couldn't get no hits. People weren't listening to my music when I first came out. I was getting no love anywhere, and I just had to, you know, keep putting music out there and letting people know, and then things started to change. People realized what I was out to do. They realized the movement that I had, and then everything started to change. But you got to have the passion. Without the passion, you won't last.
Exactly. And I mean, we ask this question to like almost every artist that comes on, and they all say, you know, you got to persevere. And I mean, that reigns true with anything that you love. If it's worth it, it's not going to be easy, right?
Oh, you got to love it. You got to love it. And, you know, if people will realize it. People will test you. They want to see, like, there's so many fly-by-night artists. They want to see if you're just a one-track guy or if you're really going to be putting out hits consistently every month and putting out hot mixtapes, putting out hot videos consistently so people know that you're a force to be reckoned with and you're here to do business and you came to play with the big boys, right?
All right. Okay, you're listening to 90.1 FM, also broadcasting online through TNT Events Radio. My name's Terrence Evans, and we're cutting for a short commercial break and a PSA. We'll be right back after this with Master Jedi Ray Gill from Surrey, BC.
What turns 15 on February 28th and has won the 2012 Best Practices in Higher Education Award? What has expanded its locations and now hosts a new venture, Book Salons? The answer is the Philosopher's Cafe. Now in more areas in the Lower Mainland, there's more choices to discuss, more new people to meet, and more time to expand your mind and unseal your creativity. All information like dates, topics, locations, times are on the website at www.philosopherscafe.net.
In. All right, and we're back after those brief announcements. Thank you for all of our sponsors, all the people listening to the show across the world in the different stations and also online. If you'd like, please drop us a line at info@thisisvancouveronline.ca. We're back here with Ray Gill. Ray, let's play another tune. What's the other tune that we've got?
Okay, the next tune is with my brother, Brad Influence. It's called Champagne Wishes, and it's just a party track. And I want to say, Terrence, I want to thank you for breaking boundaries, inviting me on the show, and letting me showcase my music, bro.
Not a problem, man. That's why we're here, right? We're here for the artists. We're not here for the sponsors. We're here for the sponsors to get their stuff out to all the people that listen. We do get about 2 million hits after every month. On any one of the shows we do, which is 10-minute quickie, Around the World in 5 Hours, and even the 17-minute tongue lash. So, you know, if you are an artist and you want to get your stuff out there, 87 countries listen to us, whether we do one show a month or 5 shows a month. This is, what's the name of the song, Ray?
Champagne Wishes.
Champagne Wishes. We'll be right back.
We do it for the riches, champagne wishes, caviar dreams and Bugatti bitches, all about a business, champagne wishes, penthouse living, champagne wishes. We do it for the riches, champagne wishes, caviar dreams, and Bugatti bitches, all about a business. Champagne wishes, penthouse living, champagne wishes, wishes.
Yeah, I'm smoking that Keisha,
Keisha?
Splurging all on my Visa.
She the student, I'm the teacher.
You can tell the bitch I don't need her.
Need her?
Next week I'ma leave her.
Leave her.
Come back next Easter.
Easter.
Hate the cash that I'm making.
Making.
Puffing on the Jamaican.
Making.
Fuck with me, you get Nathan.
Making.
Illuminati like Satan.
Making.
Friday night just like Jason.
Jason.
Girls giving, I'm taking.
Making.
I seen the Pilates, you working them heels.
Hills, hills.
Shaking your body, you know that you got me, you keeping it real. Brown boy creating my lane. Fuck all the bullshit, fuck all the fame. I do it today and I do it for game.
Riches, champagne wishes, caviar dreams, and Bugatti bitches, all about a business. Champagne wishes, penthouse living, champagne wishes. We do it for the riches, champagne wishes, caviar dreams, and Bugatti bitches, all about a business. Champagne wishes, penthouse living, champagne wishes, wishes.
Popping up on the bottles, sitting up in the club. VIP gets swallowed, everyone showing me love. Bitches be popping the Miley, haters be popping the mug. Hotties be shaking their bodies, been making me pop like a drug. Hard as you was, we up above, thicker than blood. My homie be fire, them old ass rappers keep rhyming and talking. We young and we make them retire. Handle this like business, we don't need no witness. From Van City to New Orleans, we Super Bowl and winning. That's word to my fiance, that's hotter than Beyonce. That's word to Kim and Kanye, let's die up for Illuminati. And way so swagged out. If you ain't in here to ball, what you came for?
We do it for the riches, champagne wishes, caviar dreams, and Bugatti bitches, all about a business. Champagne wishes, penthouse living, champagne wishes. We do it for the riches, champagne wishes, caviar dreams, and Bugatti bitches, all about a business. Champagne wishes, penthouse living, champagne wishes, wishes.
All right, Ray, that was a good party song. I mean, is that primarily a Surrey what song?
Well, definitely, I'm representing Vancouver now, but you know, I grew up in Surrey for a few years, and that down south crunk, wild style, that's kind of reminiscent of Surrey. It's also reminiscent of kind of like that down south movement, the trap kind of movement that's kind of coming up from down south, and it's
exactly.
Kind of fully coming up here on the West Coast. So, I'm very influenced by music from the South and from California.
Mm-hmm.
So I really kind of try to, mix that in with the Canadian aspect too, so you get like a real unique kind of blend, because I'm really influenced by California and down south, but at the same time I still bring that Canadian flavor to it. So
okay, Ray, what do you got coming up? You said you're primarily working out of Vancouver right now, right?
Yes.
Okay, so what kind of stuff do you have coming up, like collaborations? Do you have an LP or an EP or some kind of release coming out, or what do you have going on, let's say, within the next month or 3 months?
Yeah, well, we make classics. All our music, if you go online and you check it out, the music is quality. It's right up to par with the stuff that's hot today. And we're making classic music. So we're making just great, music that's going to, expand over the years. And, Ray Gill Music, that's where I'm at. Facebook, Twitter. I'm working on a mixtape right now, The Brown King.
Okay.
My second mixtape. It's fire. It's hot. The first mixtape, we got over 5,000 downloads on that Piff.
Wow.
Over 10,000 downloads, and counting, just worldwide and then Canada. So we're really, really happy about the response. So I took it up a notch for this one. I'm working with some new people, some new producers, and this one's even going to be a step above. I just try to grow and get better with every mixtape I put out. So
Exactly. All right, so when are you expecting that mixtape to come out?
Oh, that mixtape is coming out this year, but it's not going to be out for at least another I would say at least a couple months. We're only about 5-6 songs in right now. So
okay, all right. And so for events for the summer, do you have anything that you're doing over the summer?
We got lots of stuff happening. Lots of outdoor parties, indoor parties, club nights. You just got to add me Facebook Radio Music, Twitter Radio Music, and stay up to date. Catch me online, and I'm updating all that stuff every day, man. And we're getting new opportunities, new shows every day. Something's coming up, so it's an exciting time right now for Canadian hip hop. And if you already know, at the Much Music VMAs, we got 3 artists from Vancouver that are nominated. We got Sunreal, we got Mad Child, and Matt Brevner. So, we're coming, and we're ready to knock the doors down for Vancouver and Canada this year. So.
Beautiful, beautiful. All right, we're going to play you out with your last song here. What is that last song?
This is a song that's called Get It Poppin'. It's kind of like a swag, urban track, and it's just about, getting it poppin' and, having a good time. So it's just a positive track for the...
Okay, go for it.
What's up? My name is Ray Gill, and you're listening to Around the World with Terrence Evans. Yo, what's up? My name is Ray Gill. You can catch me at Ray Gill Music, raygill.net. And you're listening to... Okay, now I can do it for sure.
Okay, all right. Go ahead.
Okay. My name is Ray Gill. Catch me at raygill.net or Facebook, Twitter, Ray Gill Music. And you're listening to Podest. This is VancouverOnline.ca.
Awesome. Thank you, man. All right, so we're busting out here with Ray Gill's last song. And Ray, thank you for coming on to the show. We're now going to blast over to Halifax. All right, thanks, Ray.
And when it feels like you can't go on, just keep your head so strong. Just live your life to the end.
To the end, to the end.
Just breathe in the sweet air. Feels like you're already there. No one can hold you down.
Hold you down, hold you down.
I see you bitching, acting tough. You know this is love. You want me, baby, can't get enough.
That's right.
I'm ready to call you bluff. You acting tough, you want it rough. Game, recognized game, I see you. Passion never see through. Not a hater, but I hate to leave you. The end is not coming, we hot, running. Take it to the top, stunting. First class flight, room service, you deserve it. Yeah, we living so good, so never tripping. Bedroom friction, Trojans on the ground. You loving the sound, I'm the king, baby girl, where's my crown? Ray Gill, hold it down. In that pussy, I'ma drown. In that pussy, I'ma drown.
Swag,
And when it feels like you can't go home, just keep your head so strong. Just live your life to the end.
To the end, to the end.
Just breathe in the sweet air. Feels like you're already there. No one can hold you.
Wake up, wake up, living a dream. I'ma put you on the team. You know me, rolling joints up in the sand, calling me your man. I'm in the forest like Tarzan, your ex acting so mad. I'm living plush life, 5-star suites, sports car whipping, Molly tripping, rum sipping. Yeah, you know that we winning, flamingos and jackpots. You know that it's mad hot, outrageous. I can't stop, and I will just not. Lady, you like my motivation, and the fact that I'm never hating, and I'm always spoiling you when we dating. Keeping it real, I'm never faking. Welcome to my meditation. Listen to me on the station. I'm having fun while you waiting. Hop in the whip and let's go, go, go.
When it feels like you can't go home, just keep your head so strong. Just live your life to the end.
To the end, to the end.
Just breathe in the sweet air. Feels like you're already there. No one can hold you down.
Hold you down, hold you down.
And when it feels like you can't go home, your head so strong, just live your life to the end.
To the end, to the end.
Just breathe in the sweet air. Feels like you're already there. No one can hold you down.
Hold you
The Urban Native Youth Association Connections Program is looking for volunteer mentors to act as friends and role models for Aboriginal youth ages 15 to 19. Our hope is that the friendships formed will be lifelong and help support youth as they are transitioning from long-term care to independent living. If you are at least 19 years of age and willing to commit a minimum of 2 hours a week for 1 year, please contact the Connections Coordinator at the Urban Native Youth Association by phone at 604-254-7732 or fax at 604-254-5630.
Two, one.
Hey, yo, it's Nadeem, a.k.a. No More Mr. Nice Guy, representing that Saga City all damn day, and you're listening to This Is Vancouver Online. Go check it out, or else you suck.